I just can't shake you, shake you, shake, shake, shake you. Out of my dreams, out of my head, fade to a memory that's lost.
I just can't shake.
Out of my dreams, out of my head, fade to a memory that's lost.
I just can't shake.
Out of my dreams, out of my head, fade to a memory that's lost instead.
Thank you.
I love it. Miss Felix Unger there. We're going to talk to Sarah some more and everything. I just love, don't you like that?
I do.
I'm thinking.
Yes.
I got
a girl crush.
Well, they're playing. I'm thinking Felix Unger at the Brandywine Zoo. I haven't saw that on their, looked at it on the website.
Yeah,
I haven't seen that.
That.
You know,
right.
Yeah. You know,
right.
Wouldn't that be a Saturday?
Yeah,
Saturday right. Afternoon. Felix Unger at the Brandywine. How are you, Jill?
Very good.
Yeah.
It is so nice to be here.
Yeah,
I'm always excited to come on the show.
You've been doing it for quite a few years.
Yeah, I'm 23. Yeah, I'm 22 of my 23 years.
And that's, right? Yeah, yeah. But you always come on. We talk about the Brandywine Zoo.
We're
usually, you know, sometimes you come on with critters and other times you come on with things. And I'm sitting here.
I've got two critters. Well,
you got two critters. And let's introduce everybody.
First of all, I have to say that what we do at the Brandywine Zoo, you've heard me say 100 times, we could not do without our volunteers. So I brought with me two fabulous volunteers who are our Storytime ladies. So this is Ellen Munter and Carol Welch, who are our Storytime ladies, and they're going to talk a little bit about story.
Yeah,
time.
Do you tell stories, or do you make them up, or are they true?
What do we read stories? But we embellish the stories.
You stretch it. You're kind of like Texas people then, right?
Wait a minute.
Kind of stretch
it. Better in Delaware.
Kind of stretch it out a little bit. And I guess you do that for the school kids?
Yeah, we do it for a lot of the groups in the summertime. And there's a lot of the members and just guests that come to the zoo weekly. We do it every Thursday morning at 10:30 from June through September. And we always have a different story, and then we present one of our education animals. And so sometimes the children get to pet them.
Jill, I've been saying it, you know how much I preach about the Brandywine Zoo. There is not a better zoo in any state, I firmly believe, than what we have here.
I agree.
You might be able to go somewhere else and see more animals and things like this, but you're not going to get that experience that you'll get at the Brandywine Zoo. When I say hands-on, not necessarily going up and petting a tiger or anything, but you do get that hands-on experience and people throughout the entire zoo, volunteers like these ladies and many more that will help you with anything.
They are.
Up close and personal.
Absolutely, we are up close. And we know that we're not a destination zoo. Nobody comes from Florida to come to the Brandywine Zoo. So what we're really good at, our niche is really knowing our constituents, knowing our people in Delaware, and having them come back again and again. And these ladies will testify, you know, the kids know who they are, you know.
Because they come
back.
When one
of them goes on vacation, the other one has to go, I'm so sorry, you know, Ellen's not here today.
Yeah.
Oh, where'd she go? When Ellen comes back,
then we start making up more stories. We call them liars where I'm from. Because you tell stories, I guess the stories are related to animals.
Absolutely.
Right,
and
right,
they're really, what's really good is what I'd love for people to know about them is they have taken this and made it their own. So it's not something like I say to them, here, I need you to read this story and do this craft and show this animal. Ellen and Carol have made this completely on their own. And so they decide what stories, they research them. Ellen and Carol both buy the stories for the zoo if they can't find them in the library. And then they actually come up with these great crafts that the kids all make that are related to
the zoo. So they're entertained, but that's where you come in, because you're kind of the educator of the zoo,
absolutely,
I guess.
Absolutely, I am.
And you oversee that, and you guys do so many programs. I want people to know, because the school time's coming.
Yes.
You go out on location.
We have our traveling zoo that we will go and we meet science standards, and sometimes even social studies, math, English standards for the Department of Education through the state of Delaware. And we can come to your facility, you can come to our facility. And on top of that, we have a really hardcore mission of educating about wildlife conservation. So no matter where you see us, even in story time, they tie it right back to conservation and what we can do to make a difference.
Right.
So if everybody just does one thing to make a difference, we're all making a difference.
Yeah, I was really surprised. One of the different things that you did at the zoo, I want to get this out here because the folks here in the audience aren't going to be able to see him tonight. Or is it he or her?
She.
I won't be able to see her tonight because we're going to post it, put it in post. Yeah.
But this is not her, by the way.
Yeah, it's not her. You got the new tiger.
We do. We're so excited.
Yeah.
Zana just joined us at the end of June. That was quiet. She had to go in quarantine. We had to get used to her, our keepers, and then the keepers, she had to get used to us. So it was a getting to know you phase, and she made her debut earlier this month, and she is out, she is beautiful. You can come and see her, and I invite you, Tim, you gotta come out and see her.
We're coming out.
This is what Zana would look like if we were to ask her to smile.
It is a tiger.
It is a tiger skull. Yeah. And this just shows you the teeth. So when people say to me, do you ever climb in the exhibit with Zana? I like to show this and say, would you? would you want to climb in there with this?
No.
She would look at me and say,
lunch.
Well, dinner. I'm dinner. All you can eat buffet. So she would definitely say that. And so she's a young tiger. So she's very active, loves to swim.
Loves to play,
We've been doing enrichment for her, which is putting out boxes. So sometimes people walk past and they go, oh, what's that trash doing in there? It's an old pizza box, but stuffed with things, taped clothes, hanging in a tree. And she swats at it.
Just like a normal house cat.
Absolutely.
You have to have something to play with. And
absolutely.
So you guys are having to do that.
Sure.
And
so
we
give her different treats. She loves goat's milk, so the keepers spray that in her mouth. She is fascinated with, it's interesting to watch her get used to the zoo and watch her getting used to children and walking by, and sometimes people are very fascinating and she kind of hunts them.
Right.
That's always exciting for me as an educator to watch.
Take these bars down.
Exactly.
Well, you got something big coming up. We got to get that out there. Zippity Zoo Days coming up. Yeah.
September 10th and 11th, so we encourage you to come out. You can see Zana.
Fiesta on 924 and fall programs for families.
Yes.
You can find it all on
www.brandywinezoo.org. You can see that. And the whole complement of our lineup of programs, including the dates of our story times, the dates of all of our events that you just mentioned, as well as our other programs. We have lots of other programs for families, preschoolers, adults, all sorts of things. You can go on there, look under the calendar.
I'm
going
to give you your own show one of these days.
Shut
up. They're over there doing this. I'm like, there we go. It says Brandywine Zoo. Big hand for the ladies.
Yay!
Put your hands together. Felix Unger, take us out.
I wish you would laugh just a little more. And I wish you would smile a little more. And I wish you would breathe a little more feeling, a little more compassion, just a little more. Complacent thoughts and endless riddles.